President Biden is asking black barbershops and beauty salons to help get more Americans vaccinated. This is all a part of his month of action ahead of his goal to get 70% of Americans vaccinated by July 4th. BNC's Derrick Lewis is in Houston with details of the plan and reaction from Barbers.
Mike Brown cuts hair at the Shop Spa in Washington, D.C. He also talks to his clients who are not vaccinated or hesitant.
To stop the spread of the coronavirus that's wreaking havoc in our community at an extremely alarming rate, if the vaccine is plan A, then what is your plan B if you're not going to take the shot?
The effort is part of Shots at the Shops, President Biden's new initiative to educate black communities on the vaccine with the help of everyone to reach the goal.
Private sector, and most importantly, the American people, to get to the 70% mark.
Mike also does outreach in the community.
We give flyers and put flyers out. We have a guy here cooking, giving free food. Everybody likes something for free. So you got to reel them in while you're giving them the information.
In Houston, at the Stage Barbershop, there is no talk about the vaccine. Barber Joshua Merritt believes there shouldn't be any pressure to get vaccinated.
Any individual, no matter what their race is, they should go look up what's in this vaccine, the effects of the vaccine, and whether it's for them or not.
Joshua believes the effort does not help with the lack of trust some in black communities have with the government.
With as strong as the opposition is with the white community with vaccines, why somebody has to let me know why they're so focused on the black community.
According to the CDC, black Americans' vaccination rates are lower than others. However, Joshua does not think there should be a community push to get more people vaccinated.
I'm skeptical, but I'm not against somebody deciding for themselves to get the vaccine.
Mike wants people to feel safe than sorry.
I'm gonna wait a little more. But your folks just died, man. What are you doing? What if you catch it? You know, what about your grandma? What about your auntie?
You know, I love that piece.
Derrick Lewis. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Derrick Lewis reporting there. Yeah, he asked the question, why are they so focused on the black community? Well, I'll tell you why they're so focused on the black community. And once again, I'm not pushing the vaccine on anybody. It's your choice. You do what you want to. It's your body. But it's going to help you and it helps the black community because, as you know, the virus has affected us in a disproportionate rate, more so than anybody else in this community here in the United States. We have underlying conditions, and when we get infected by it, a lot of us die. A lot of us stay sick, and the after effects that are happening with the coronavirus is devastating. So less than a quarter of black people in this country have been vaccinated. Mm-hmm. One shot. Not even one shot. Mm-hmm. That's low. And it's available to you.
Yeah.
I think it's within 5 miles. They got Uber rides that they get set up and they have you taken out
there.
A lot of it is just hesitancy. And they're trying. So once again, we need to do our due diligence. Do your research. Understand, what's going on in your body. You're taking a chance when it comes to that. But I would say the reward far outweighs the risk for right now.
Mike, to touch on what you're saying, we were just doing a report last week about this, and I saw that a reporter did a nice report there, really getting to the heart of things, getting into barbershops where people are talking about this a lot and where people trust their barber like they trust their doctor sometimes. That's just the reality. You get to know them. You often have a long relationship. Your kids end up going to the same barber, so you trust them. So it's interesting, that this is part of the strategy now for the Biden administration to get to the heart of where these conversations are really happening and trying to get them even with doctors' offices as well, because you tend to, in a lot of minority communities, you end up going to the same doctor, you tend to trust your doctor. But I think it's interesting that 80% of hospitalizations, even in D.C., have been in the past week or two of African-Americans. People of color are making up the hospitalizations.
Yes.
And it's not just D.C., it's other cities too. In parts of Memphis, they're seeing hospitalization rates among African-Americans go up. There's been a surge in this. As other folks have been getting the vaccine, you're seeing this hospitalization rate of people of color going up. 70 million vaccines have been shipped out, but they haven't been administered.
Right.
And now, just in the past week, the Biden administration sending it out potentially to other countries around us who do need the vaccines and are looking at America and saying, hey, those won't stay on the shelves too long. So why not, you know, send it over here? And that's what they're now looking to do. So we have the supply. That's the crazy thing. We were asking for the supply. Yeah.
Yeah, and the supply far outweighs the demand. It's not just black people. Obviously, there are a lot of people on the, non-black people who are hesitant to take the vaccination as well. And we can understand. And look, you know, we know the history of this country when it comes to healthcare and the atrocities. We know about the Tuskegee experiment. But once again, this is a virus that is affecting everybody. If it was something that said, hey, you know what? All of a sudden, you got this cure for sickle cell, not tested for FDA approval or whatever, and we're just going to just throw these in the arms of black people, whatever. Even if you don't have sickle cell, let's just do it just so that your kids don't have sickle cell. You might be a little worried because it's going into one group of people, right? Mm-hmm. And you don't know if it's going to be tested that way. And we know sickle cell affects black people more so than any other color out there, and also Hispanics. But at the same time, this is affecting everybody in this country, and not just this country, but in this world. The doses that they're putting in white people's arms and Latinos' arms and Indians' arms and Asians' arms is going in your arm. And there's nothing that's different about it. So, yeah, once again, you can do your research. And I know it's not fully FDA approved, but it is an effective measure by some really smart people, smart minds from around the world who've come together to come up with this vaccine in a quick fashion to save lives and hopefully save your life. So we just hope that you'll do your research and not listen to all the conspiracy theories that are out there, because there are a lot of crazy ones out there.